you love me, please don't judge me. Got my hands tied, the power's above me. Don't shoot the messenger, I'm just a puppet here. If you wanna place blame, then look to the puppeteer. Family, fortune, envy, jealousy, privilege, passed on, legacy, secret, sabotage, borderline, felony, suicide, subtract, selfish, pedigree, yeah.
How's it going, everybody? C-RadTV back here in another video, and welcome to C-RadTV vlog number 52. So for today's vlog, I'm up at my grandma's currently because I'll be heading down to the Nascar Canada Series race at Canadian Tire Motorsports Park for the Labor Day sprint. So as now we're in the last month of the Canada Series season, the sprint to the finish decide who will be our 2024 champion. As it's really down between three drivers, Laqua, Ranger, and Cameron, with Cameron having a big championship lead coming into this weekend. But a lot still on the table to be decided with three races to go. As those three still are the three to beat, as all three have combined to win all 10 races so far this year. With three races left, time is running out for anybody not named Laqua, Ranger, Cameron to win a race this year. So, going to be an interesting race. A lot of championship implications on the line for this race, as two of the last three are in Ontario before the finale up in Montmagny, Quebec, which will be the first time since NASCAR took the license over that the series finale will not be held in Ontario. So, with only three races left, still a wide open championship between those three. Who could win the title? Who will be sent to Elimination Station? Gonna be interesting these next couple weeks with CTMP and then Delaware next week to decide that. So yeah, just chilling here at my grandma's place, getting ready to go. So I'll see you out the car when I'm ready to leave. Alright, officially on the road to CTMP. We got a 3.5 hour drive. Let's roll. All right, we're officially inside Canadian Tire Motorsports Park. Let's head on over and check in.
Titus Sherlock setting the second fastest lap. Calls after an unscheduled pit.
Outside in turn, Canada, presented by Pinty's and Wigan Speedway, Chevrolet, Chevrolet number 0, Glenn Stires. Bowmanville, Ontario. The Big Feet Snacks, E3 Spark Plugs, O'Neill Electric Supply, number 84, Larry Jackson. Quebec, the Recap Recovery Drink, K-Fiber Optic Pulleys, Truck Stop Chevrolet, number 66, Dexter Stacy. 17th, from Stouffville, Ontario. The Wiser Leland Industry Chevrolet number 3, Jason Hathaway.
DJ Kennington.
The Castro Ledge Brimstone Games CIM Metals Dodge number 17, DJ Kennington. Donut de Montcalm, Quebec. The Pro Bomb Controls JC Perot E-Racer Sports Ford number 1, J.B. Here, Quebec, the WeatherTech Canada OmniFab Dodge number 47, L.B. Dumoulin. 7th, from Achenay, Quebec, the St. Hubert Aerobat Chevrolet number 80, Alex Tagliani.
Sorry.
Silverton, Ontario, the MBS Motorsports Sierra Excavating 22 Racing Chevrolet number 22, Kyle Stepley. Fifth, from Victoriaville, Quebec, the AB Express Lucier Chevrolet VR Victoriaville number 36, Alex LeBay. Starting fourth, from St. Leonard, Gaston, Quebec, the GM Paillet Chevrolet Canada number 96, Marc Antoine Cameron. Third, from Roxton Pond, Quebec, the GM Paillet Chevrolet Canada number 27, Andrew Ranger. And that race fans, your front row, starting second. From Halton Hills, Ontario, the Bothwell Accurate Hoffman Plastics Dodge number 59, Gary Clute. And your pole sitter, starting first with a time of 1 minute 21.809 seconds, a new track record from Saint-Eustache, Quebec, the Adaptive One Calipers Napa Racing Dodge number 74, Kevin Lacroix.
I was wondering why your chair was.
Start your engines!
Turn three.
I would say is Dexter.
Now the red flag is out to clean up all the mess down in turn three.
shops.
That's what's left of Dexter Stacy car in turn three. The entire left side is gone.
They clean up in turn number three. The
third lap in, second time this weekend. Similar mishaps. It's things you don't see every day, and we're thankful.
And the yellow flag is now back out after being under red for about 25 minutes.
From the inside of row number one, he gets to fire first because this is a restart count in the original start. Start of the Pinty's restart zone.
Now they begin that uphill climb to the top of turn number two, and it's the ball. And that number 74 car with the lead, Ranger 27, has moved the ramp.
Thank you.
74.
Red flag back out again for more repairs on the tire barrier in turn three. That poor barrier can't catch a break today. Yellow flag is now back out.
Stop there at the end of the back straightaway.
Cameron in the 96.
Didn't look like the opportunity was going to come until that late race yellow. Boy, oh boy, you had to make some dynamic moves when that race restarted. Talk about the restart and get into the end.
I was so happy when I saw the yellow. I was very sad that the old race when I saw it was like 14th. But then when I saw yellow, I was so happy. I knew that we had fresher tires on everybody. So the first six cars were with the tires advantage, they were pretty easy to overtake, and we got one go with one car to pass, and we had to do what we had to do. It happened something in practice yesterday morning, so I was happy to win that.
There you have it, Kevin Lacroix, the winner of the WeatherTech 200. Second place, he led a lot of laps here this afternoon. Mark Antoine Cameron, it's not always where you want to be, out in front of the white flag. Talk about that.
I'm proud of my team. I think we have a really good strategy until the end. You know, with the 8 laps to go, the yellow comes out and doesn't get the board. He can make a pass, a clean pass. Well, he got 4 tires, and it's good for a championship. We put 4 points ahead of the 27. That's the most important thing. And I hear too that it's really important inside. We have two races to go, so we can't stop.
Mark Antoine Cameron with his classic smile comes home with a second place. Exactly. Holy moly. Without that yellow flag, you did not need that yellow at the end in terms of there were cars with fresh tires, and they have a whole season worth of hard feelings that they take out in the end. Talk about what you went through those last few laps.
Yeah, it's just hard racing. I mean, I was on the outside camera in there on the start, and we held with them, and I probably should have pulled in line going through two, but I was just trying to get them there, and then I was just trying to stay behind them until the end. and Lacroix came charging pretty hard and aggressive, but he had a really good car. But I'm just super thankful for MBS Motorsports here excavating, Jeff and Dominic for making it happen, and everybody here, we had a great car. It was a lot of fun charging through the field there when we took the two tires, but the caution maybe hurt us a little bit, but just the way it all played out, and really proud of the third place finish, but like to be two spots better next time.
Remember the name, folks. Kyle Steckley comes home third here this afternoon. Marc-Antoine Cameron, second place finish. As he continues his conversation, second place finish, head up to the podium. And now Kevin Lacroix to the top step. We send Tony and Joe from WeatherTech up to present that hardware. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a round of applause for your podium in today's WeatherTech 200? We're going to get this trophy presented, and then the champagne's going to fly, and possibly the once again, the WeatherTech 200 top three. Kevin Lacroix, Marc-Antoine Cameron, and Kyle Steckley. Yay!
I'll have to check that out. Thanks for watching, we appreciate it.
That was left of what's Dexter Stacy's car from earlier on. That's the most fucked up I've ever seen a car get in a race in my entire life. Damn. Back out of the car, so Kevin Lacroix wins at CTMP now for the eighth time in his career. So the road course merchant in the Canada Series wins again at the track he owns like the back of his hand. So now we got a 3.5 hour drive back home. I'll talk to you when we get back.
All right, I'm back up north to my grandma's place. So just gonna chill here for the night, watch the rest of the Southern 500, and see who makes the chase and who's out. But yeah. Kevin Lacroix gets the win at CTMP, his eighth win at the track, his fourth of the season. Yeah, Lacroix's having one of the best seasons of his career. And his road course resume continues to be impressive as the road course merchant wins yet again. And honestly, in terms of his move on camera, I'm not really surprised. That's like a vintage Lacroix move. Oh, Lacroix always tends to do that once he's got close to somebody on a road course or short track, so not even surprised in the slightest. Especially since, Lacroix was in a must-win situation. He was going to be desperate once he got the camera. And I knew that once if Lacroix got the camera's rear bumper, that move was coming. Saw it coming from a mile away. But, you know, hey, at the end of the day, you know, Cameron still got second good points day. Only lost 3 points to Lacroix in the championship and gained a bunch on Ranger. So, yeah, Lacroix, he may have won the battle, but Cameron's most likely going to win the war with two races to go as we now head to Delaware next week for the penultimate race of the season. Going to be weird not seeing Delaware as the season finale this year since Mont Maggie has the finale and it's the first time in Canada Series history the finale is not in Ontario. So, yeah, that about wrap it up for this vlog. So, yeah, pretty good experience at CTMP. Thank God Dexter Stacy's okay after that horrible crash he had early in the race. Like, Jesus Christ. Like, that's the most fucked up I've ever seen a car get in my lifetime. I've seen some bad crashes, but dear God, that car was so messed up. It was hard to even fathom it. Like, there was even a hole in the goddamn windshield on the driver's side in the corner. It's like, dear God. And I did see the video of what happened. It's like, Jesus Christ, just lost the brakes, went right into the barrier and hopped and went, got airborne and landed right on top. Just, dear God. Thank God Dexter Stacy was able to walk away from that, because that was a horrible crash for Stacy. Dear God, you know, even despite all the safety advancements NASCAR's made the last two decades in the sport, you know, just Dexter Stacy's crash today is just another friendly reminder of how dangerous auto racing and motorsports truly are. Like, hell, you could wrap the cars and drivers in bubble wrap and shit like that would still happen. But yeah, you know, that's just part of the game. You know, at least Dexter Stacy was able to walk away uninjured, so that was good to see. Along with Jason Hathaway. But Stacy, man, just dear God. But yeah, that car was just so messed up. Like, it was even hard to fathom what happened. Especially when the entire left side was completely gone. But yeah, that'll wrap it up for this vlog for CTMP. The next vlog on this channel will be next Sunday for the Canada Series race at Delaware Speedway. The race that was supposed to happen a couple weeks ago when Space Mel Ferrari 248 was down, but Mother Nature chose to ruin those collab plans. So yeah. See, I'll still go to Delaware, have a fun time, you know. Just wish at the end of the day I still could have done that experience at Space Mel Ferrari 248. Don't worry, buddy. Someday you'll experience a NASCAR Canada Series race day experience. Someday. But anyway, that'll wrap it up here. That's all I gotta say. Hope everyone has a great day. I'll see you all later. I'm out.